beach and various local places. It's only as a information for members to digest and consider. So I think it's simple as you see as a page. So the healthcare performance panel, this panel looks in detail at some of the issues across the healthcare system. And in particular, the meeting of the panel really focused in on some of the preparation for these pressures, issues around hospital discharge and pressures around the hospital. What they've looked at in some detail is the whole range of services that could be described as early support discharge services and the use of the £34 million and aggressive care transformation for renewables to help healthcare to deliver services across in a much more integrated way to commission services across the world. So there's some information and detail there about how that's being taken forward. And the key elements here relate to ongoing requirement to scrutinise how that system works, because it's quite critical to the whole health and care of all the people in the world.
I think it's
probably important to say that in terms of the detailed monitoring of these elements, and there is a group called the System Resilience Group, which is a statutory body made up of people from health and care, both from rural but also broader than rural in terms of NHS England and the North West Ambulance Service, etc. So there is detailed monitoring that goes along with this, but I think this is very much about identifying some areas that need further work. And I know that within the conclusion there is the need to have a more detailed deep dive on how admissions avoidance is working, or the focus on supporting people outside of hospital so that they need to go in for unplanned reasons. Maybe people do need to go in for unplanned reasons. This is unplanned care. So I think they're the key elements of the report.
No specific recommendations to the agency's safeguard ensuring the scrutiny review remains to be completed, but we hope very much that the report will be included on the future agenda on the 2nd of November. The first meeting of the avoiding admissions task the finish group was on last week, which we discussed the scope of the review. Members, everybody, are very welcome to make any further suggestions. Include some sort of alert program. And the chair has asked to report regarding day centres and the establishment of rural evolutions.
figures included tonight for that. They were in our lab. But I think I saw, I'm sure, and I'm like, if Cllr has to come back and give us an update, there's a lot of concern around the contract at the time, it would be good if they come back. If you pop them on webinar and ask them to come back and give us a further update on how things are going, a further presentation, I think that's a good idea.
It's something that was discussed at the last meeting with the Chair's person, so I need to follow that up with the Jury.
Okay, thanks. So, we will be updating the policy. Performance of the